Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Shrimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacya Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Vayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So we're hearing from the Srimad Bhagavatam 6th canto, and we're hearing about the life of Ajamila and how he was saved from going to having to go to Yamaraj. He was saved by the Vishnu Dutas.
我们学的是圣典博伽瓦堂的第六篇，在前面我们学到了阿迦弥勒的生平，以及阿迦弥勒在要去到地狱之前是如何被维什努都塔所拯救的。And
the Yamaduras were very disturbed that at being defeated by the Vishnu Dutas because they had never been defeated before.
这些亚玛都塔感觉到非常受到打扰，因为他们被维什努都塔给击败了，而且他们以前从来没有这样被打败过，所以他们内心是有一些波澜的。So
they went back to Yamaraj and they asked Lord Yamaraj about what had happened.
所以这些亚玛都塔就回到亚玛拉吉那里去，他们想去问问亚玛拉吉，问一问个究竟。
And so Yamaraj explained to them how he is not the Supreme, that there's a person over him, the Supreme Personality of Godhead is over him.
Yamaraj就像Yamadutaman解释到，他并不是至尊，而且有一位至尊人格守神是超越于他的。And
Yamaraj also explained to the Yamaduras about the importance about the power of devotees who chant the holy name of the Supreme Lord.
而且亚玛拉吉也向亚玛都塔给解释了这些唱诵主圣名的这些奉献者他们是如何的有力量。But
first of all, he describes those people who are not attracted to the chanting of the holy name.
在这之前他还向亚玛都塔们解释了那些
And these people are very attached to family life and they're only thinking about economic development, material prosperity. And if they think about anything, they think about going to the higher planets, heavenly planets, to enjoy life there.
而且他们脑子里面想着是如何能够去到高等的星兽，在那里进行享受。So
Yamaraj tells the Yamaduras that intelligent people, though solve the problems of life by devotional service.
Yamaraj 给亚玛都塔讲到，就是说。 那些智者是通过，是他们会决定从事奉献，在这一生会决定从事奉献服务。And
the most important part of devotional service is chanting the holy name of the Supreme Lord.
而最主要的奉献服务的部分就是唱诵至尊主的圣名。So
Lord Yamaraj says that those people who are doing this, who are chanting the holy name, that they can never be punished by me. I have no power in my, I don't have the power to punish or to can do anything with these people.
那些从事唱诵圣名的这些奉献者，对于我来说，我根本没有权利去惩罚他们。
He said, usually these people who are chanting the holy name, they never do any sinful activities.
通常情况下，这些唱诵圣名的奉献者，他们从来不从事罪恶活动。
But even if somehow, if they make some mistake and they do something sinful just by chance, then they're protected from sinful reactions because they chant the holy name.
即便由于失误或者受到迷惑，他们从事了罪恶活动，他们也会因为唱诵的圣名而得到了保，得最终会得到保护。
Even if somebody is a very big scholar of the Vedas, he may not be aware of the existence of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
而即便是一个非常伟大的博学者，他们也并不可能完全的认识到至尊主的名字。
He may not know about the name or the fame or the qualities of the Supreme Lord.
他们或许认识不到至尊人格守神的名字、品质以及他的活动。
But somebody may not be a big scholar, but if he understands the position of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and somehow or other he becomes a pure devotee by doing devotional service.
而一个不是大学者的人，他或许由于某种原因而从事了奉献服务，却可能成为主的纯粹的奉献者。
So he's able to understand the position of the Supreme Lord.
这样一位纯粹奉献者却能了解至尊人格守神的地位。
So Yamaraj is saying that those people who do devotional service to the Supreme Lord, they are very intelligent.
Yamaraj 就说到，那些对至尊主从事奉献服务的人，他们是非常有智慧的。
But somebody may be a Vedic scholar, he may not understand Krishna's name, fame and qualities.
但是一个人也许他是一个很大的学者，但却他并不知道 Krishna 的名字和品质。
But a pure devotee is one who's got a clear brain.
而一个纯粹奉献者，他的智慧是很纯洁的。
And he engages in the service of Krishna.
他从事着对 Krishna 的奉献服务。
And he does that, he does service for Krishna, not just to make a show, but he actually serves Krishna with love.
他为 Krishna 做奉献服务不是一种表演，他是用爱心在为 Krishna 做服务。
And he will use his body, mind and words for the service of Krishna.
他会用他的心意、言语和躯体来服务 Krishna。
But somebody who is not a devotee, they may make a show of being religious, but it's not very meaningful, has no meaning.
但如果一个人他是一个非奉献者，他或许会做一些奉献服务的表演，但是却毫无意义。
They may make a show, they make a show, the show every, let everybody see them go to the temple or they go to the church. But they're not thinking about God, they're thinking about something else.
他们或许会做一个表演，说我去了庙宇，我去了教堂，我去见了神。他们内心想却不是神，他们想的是其他的东西。
So these people,They don't really know what the religious duty is.
这样的一些人，他们并不知道宗教的职责是什么。
So they get punished by Yamaraj because they didn't do their religious duty.
因此，这样的一些人会被 Yamaraj 所惩罚，因为他们并没有从事他们的宗教的职责。
But a devotee, he may do something sinful, but he does it by mistake, or by accident. So he gets forgiven for it.
但是一个奉献者，他如果由于偶然或者说意外从事了一些 罪恶的活动，但是他会得到至尊主的宽恕。
He may do something bad, something sinful, because in the past he had, you know, bad habits in the past.
他或许会从事一些罪恶活动，或者说一些不好的事情，这是由于他过去的这个习惯还存在。
So, Prabhupada said, this is the power of the Sankirtan movement, that it protects a person from sinful reactions.
圣帕帕地说，这就是 Sankirtan 运动的力量，它能够保护一个奉献者。
So Yamaraj tells his servants, he says, do not go to those people who are devotees of the Supreme Lord.
Yamaraj 告诉他的仆人说，请不要去接近这样的一位至尊主的一位奉献者。
Those people who are his devotees, they have surrendered to his lotus feet, so they are equal to everyone.
这样的一个奉献者，他完全臣服真主的莲花足，也平等待每一个人。
And their glories are appreciated and sung about by the demigods.
他们的荣耀甚至被这些半神人们所欣赏。
So Yamaraj tells the Yamaduras, he said, you should not even go near them.
Yamaraj 告诉 Yamaduta 说，你们甚至都不要去接近这样的一位奉献者。
Because these people are always protected by the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
因为这些人恒常地受到至尊主的至尊人格守神的保护。
And Yamaraj said, I cannot punish them, and Lord Brahma cannot punish them, and even the time factor cannot do anything to them.
Yamaraj 说，我不能够惩罚他们， Brahma 也不能惩罚他们，甚至连时间要素都没有能力去惩罚他们。
So Yamaraj is telling his servants, he's saying that, you know, whatever you did in the past, he said, okay, he said, just forget about that, whatever you did in the past, but from now on, I'm telling you, don't go near these people.
Yamaraj 告诉他的仆人，你们以前做过什么，请忘掉他，但是从现在开始起，你们不要去接近这样的奉献者。
Because these people have surrendered, they've taken shelter of the lotus feet of the Lord, and they always chant the holy name. They're always chanting the holy name of the Lord. So these people are very special, and they're very respected, and they're so special.That Lord Vishnu personally protects them.
这些人非常的特别，主威士努本人亲自保护着他们。
And Lord Vishnu comes with his club in his hand to protect them.
主威士努会带着他的神锤来保护这些奉献者。
So whatever you've done this time, from now on, you should not approach.These people, these devotees.
不管你们这次做了什么，但是从现在开始，不要去接近这样的奉献者。
Because if you do again, if you go to them again, next time you may be killed by the club of Lord Vishnu.
如果你们再一次做这样的事情的话，你们有可能会被主威士努的神锤所杀死。
Lord Vishnu has his club, and he has also his Sudarshan Chakra.To punish non-devotees.
主威士努有一个神锤，而且他还有这个神碟，可以去惩罚那些非奉献者。
So you should not risk being punished by him.
你不要冒着这样被惩罚的风险。
And even if Lord Brahma and I were to punish them.Lord Vishnu would punish us.
即便是我或者 Brahma 如果惩罚了这样的奉献者的话，主威士努也会惩罚我们。
So don't you try to do anything to these people.
因此不要再做任不要再对这样的奉献者做任何的事情。
Don't disturb these devotees anymore.
不要去再骚扰这样的奉献者。
These devotees are all like Paramahamsas. They're very exalted persons and they have no attraction for material life.
这些奉献者都是至尊天鹅般的人物。他们非常的杰出，对物质的生活毫无兴趣。
They are drinking the honey of the lotus feet of the Lord.
他们喝饮着至尊主莲花足下的甘露。
But Yamaraj tells his servants, the Yamaduras, you should bring to me those people.Who don't want to taste that honey of the Lord's lotus feet.
但是 Yamaraj 就告诉 Yamaduta, 请把那些不愿意喝饮至尊主莲花足下的品尝这样的甘露的人把他们给我带来。
Bring to me those people who will not associate with the Paramahamsas.
把那些不愿意与至尊天鹅般人物的这样的人与他们联谊的这样的一些人不愿意和他们联谊的人把他们给我带来
and bring those people who are attached to family life and material enjoyment
把那些沉迷于家庭生活以及物质享乐的人把他们带来
so you bring those people to me and I will have them punished
你把这些人带来我会惩罚他们
So Yamaraj is telling his servants about who should be brought to him, who he wants to see, who is supposed to be punished.
So Yamaraj 就告诉了他们，到底谁应该被带来，谁应该被接受惩罚。
So he mentions about the people who are very attached to materialistic life, and they're especially attached to sex enjoyment.
他描述了那些非常沉迷于物质感官享乐的，尤其是那些沉迷于性欲生活之中的人。
People are very fond of household life because they want sex. Their whole purpose is to enjoy sex.
人们特别喜欢这种家居生活，是因为他们特别喜欢性生活。
So they're always.Disturbed, they're always troubled by their way of living. Their only happiness comes that after working very hard all day and night, that they can have sex at night.
虽然他们总是受到各种的打扰，但是他们总是在辛苦之后盼望着晚上能够有这种性的生活。
So materialistic householders, they will sleep and they will have their sex. That is their enjoyment.
物质主义者，他们喜欢睡觉，也喜欢沉迷于性生活。
During the day, they're busy trying to find out where is money.
在白天的时候，他们非常的忙碌，他们在想，哪里有钱呢
？And if they get the money, they will spend it to maintain their family.
如果他们得到了钱，他们就来维系这个家庭。
So Yamaraj told his Yamadutas to bring these people to him for punishment.
所以 Yamaraj 就告诉这些 Yamaduta。请把这些人带来，我要惩罚他们。
But don't bring the devotees, because these devotees they're trying to preach Krishna consciousness.
但是不要带奉献者，因为这些奉献者总是在传播 Krishna 知觉。
Devotees are always feeling compassion for the other living entities and trying to save them from hell.
奉献者总是对其他生物、对其他众生怀有怜悯之心，总是想拯救其他生物。
So devotees should not be punished by Yamaraj.
因此，奉献者不应该受到 Yamaraj 的惩罚。
But people who are not Krishna conscious, they cannot be protected by their family members or their material life. That's not going to protect them.
但是没有 Krishna 知觉的人，他们不可能受家庭生活，他们不可能被家庭生活所保护着，他们没有这种保护伞。
So we should try to associate with people who are engaged in devotional service 24 hours a day.
因此我们应该一天24小时的和这些从事着奉献服务的这些人跟他们在一起联谊。
We may have a nice family and we have many children and many servants and we're living in our home and we're thinking these people will all protect us.
我们或许有很好的家庭，很好的家，而且我们有好的仆人，生活得也非常好。我们还会认为这些人这种家庭生活能够保护自己。
But still, death will come and take us out from this material world.
但是仍然死亡会来临，会把我们从这个物质世，从我们现在的物质状况之中给带走。
And we will be taken to Yamaraj, and we have to suffer.
然后我们就被带到 Yamaraj 那里去，然后开始遭罪。
Because we never did anything to awaken our Krishna consciousness.
因为我们从来没有为唤醒我们的 Krishna 知觉做出任何的努力。
So Yamaraj tells the Yamaduras, he said, "You bring to me those sinful people."Who will not chant the holy name of Krishna?
Yamaraj 继续说道：“请把那些不用自己的舌头唱诵至尊主 Krishna 圣名的人，把这些罪恶之人给我带来。”
I want to get those people who don't want to remember the lotus feet of Krishna even once, and they never bow down before him.
我想你们把那些在内心从来都没有记着 Krishna 哪怕一次都没有记着 Krishna 的人就把这些从来没有记着 Krishna 的人给我带来也把那些脑袋从来都没有顶拜过 Krishna 的这些人给我带来、
bring me those people who never do their dutyTowards Vishnu, they won't do any service for Lord Vishnu.
把那些从来不愿意从事对 Vishnu 服务的这些人给我带过来。
So I want to get all these fools and rascals. I should meet with them and I should deal with these people.
把这些笨蛋和恶棍都给我抓来，我要来处置他们。
So human life is meant.To please the Supreme Lord.
人体生命是为了取悦主。
And one way in which we can please Him is by following the principles of Varnashram Dharma.
而取悦主为什么的第一个方法就是我们可以遵守社会四阶层和灵性四阶段。
But in the Kali Yuga, people are very uneducated.They don't know that the real purpose in life is to go back home, back to Godhead.
但是卡利年代人们的堕落导致他们根本都不知道人生的目标是为了回归守神，回归家园。
To go back to Godhead means to go back home to the Supreme Lord, Krishna or Vishnu.
回归守神，回归家园的意思是回到至尊主威士禄的身边。
So, Yamaraj told the Yamaduras to bring these people who have forgotten their duty to Vishnu, bring them to him.
Yamaraj 说， Yamara 提问的是把那些忘记了自己的职责，忘记了主威士路的这样的一些人给我带过来。
So these people are not devotees, and so these people are all meant to be punished by Yamaraj.
这些非奉献者，这些这他们应他们理应受到 Yamaraj 的惩罚。
So then Yamaraj took a very humble mood.And he thought he was thinking of himself to be like his servants. He was thinking himself to be an offender. And he was asking to the Supreme Lord to forgive him.
Yamaraj 这个时候的心态非常的谦卑。他认为他和他的仆人们真的冒犯着。
So he speaks to the Supreme Lord. He says,My servants have committed a great offense by trying to arrest a devotee such as Ajamila.
他说，我由于我的仆人逮捕了像阿加米勒这样一位奉献者，我认为我们确实做了一个很大的冒犯。
So he says to O Supreme, who you are the oldest person, please forgive us.Because of our ignorance,
他说, oh,
we were ignorant, we did not recognize Ajamil as your servant.
他说, oh, 至尊啊, 请, 非智啊, 请你原谅我, 由于我们的无知, 我们没有认出, 愚昧无知, 我们没有认出阿加米勒是, 是您的一位仆人。
So we have made a great offense by trying to arrest him.
我们由于想要去逮捕他，因此做了巨大的冒犯。
So we come before you, we fold our hands and beg for your forgiveness.
我们双手合十向你祈祷，祈求您的原谅。
So you're always merciful, and you have so many wonderful qualities. Please forgive us.
您总是很仁慈的，拥有着很多美好的品质，请您原谅我们。
So Yamaraj is taking the responsibility for the offense committed by his servants to get them forgiven for what they did.
Yamaraj 亲自承担了他仆人所做的这个冒犯的责任。
If the servant of an establishment, if they make some mistake,then the establishment has to take responsibility for it.
在一个机关之中，如果这个仆人犯了错，那个机构会负责。
Just like sometimes people would write to Prabhupada and they would say that I met one of your devotees and he tried to sell me the book and he was very aggressive. He tried to force me to get the book and to give him money.
就像曾经有人给圣帕帕的写信，说他有人希望我去派书，然后把钱给他。
No, no, no.
No, okay.
一个人派书的时候，碰到别的人，他强迫他卖他的书，给他钱。
Okay.
明白吗？
这个奉献者强迫这个非奉献者买他的书，然后给他的钱。
So then that non-devotee wrote to Prabhupada complaining.
Okay. 然后这个非奉献者就给圣帕帕德写信抱怨这个事情。
So Prabhupada wrote back to the man and said, "I'm very sorry."
然后圣帕帕德给这一个给这个人回信说，我非常的抱歉。
So Prabhupada took the responsibility. He said, you know, he's my devotee, he's my disciple, and he didn't behave very well with you, and so I apologize on his behalf. I'm sorry.
所以圣帕帕德也承担了这个责任，承担了这个责任。他给这个 他向这个人道歉，因为这个是奉献者，他如果向你做了一些不好的事情的话，我代表他向您道歉。
So it's the same situation here. Yamaraj is taking the responsibility for the behavior of the Yamadutas.
所以在这里 ，Yamaraj 也为 Yamaduta 为他们承担责任，并代表他们道歉。
Actually, Yamaraj never made any offense.
事实上 ，Yamaraj 他并没有做出任何的冒犯。
But his servants, the Yamadutas, they went to arrest Ajamil, and that was an offense.
是他的仆人亚玛都塔去想逮捕阿加弥勒，他们做出了冒犯。
So Yamaraj has to take some responsibility for that.
所以亚玛拉吉也得为这个事情负责。
So Prabhupada quotes the Nyaya Shastra, Logic Shastra, and it says, if a servant makes a mistake, the master is punishable.
圣帕巴德在这里引用了逻辑学的一个经典，他说仆人一旦犯错的话，主人便会受到惩罚。
The master is responsible because he's responsible for the behavior of his servants.
因之所以主人会承担责任，因为主人必须为他的仆人的行为负责。
So Yamaraj was also thinking the same way.
Yamaraj 也是这么思考的。
So Yamaraj and all of his servants, they folded their hands and they prayed to the Supreme Lord and begged him to forgive them.
所以 Yamaraj 和他的仆人们就双手合十向至尊人格守神祈祷，祈求他们原谅。
So now Sukadeva Goswami is going to speak. He's going to continue giving his instruction to Maharaj Parikshit.
Swami 接下来将会继续给 Maharaj Parikshit 讲述这件事情。
That was the end of Yamaraj speaking. Yamaraj has finished giving instruction to the Yamadutas. Now Sukadeva Goswami is going to give the meaning or the significance of what happened to Maharaj Parikshit.
Yamaraj 他的仆人讲完了，现在 Sukadeva Goswami 将会我们讲出整个事情、整个事件的这个意义、道理、重要之处。
So Sukadeva Goswami tells Maharaj Parikshit that the chanting of the holy name is able to take away the reactions of even the greatest sins.
唱诵主的圣名可以根除罪恶反应。
So the chanting of the Sankirtan is the most auspicious activity in the whole universe.
祈诵圣名的这个运动是整个宇宙之中最吉祥的活动。
So Sukadeva Goswami tells Maharaj Parikshit.You should try to understand this so that others will take it seriously.
Sukadeva Goswami 说你应该好好的去理解这一点，这样的话其他人也会很严肃的对待他。
So this could be understood very clearly from this life, from this incident in relation to Ajamila's life.
这个事情被这说这么一段话可以很明确的描，就是说我们很明确的可以从阿加米勒的这一生可以看这个论据。
Ajamila chanted the holy name of the Lord, but he didn't chant it perfectly. It was not the pure name. It was Namabas. It was a shadow of the name.
阿加米勒并不是很完美的唱诵了主的圣名，他是处在一种 namabas 唱诵圣名的这个影子的这个层面上。
But because he chanted the holy name, he got freed from his sinful reactions.
但是因为他唱诵主的圣名，所以他免于了所有的罪恶反应。
So this can happen like this for everyone. Doesn't matter who they are, not just for Ajamil. Anybody who chants the holy name, they can get free from their sins by chanting.
因此，这样的事并不仅仅只是会发生在阿加米勒身上，这个是对每一个人来说很有用的一个方法。每一个人都可以唱诵主的圣名，去除他的罪恶。
But everyone should understand, you have to stop sinful. You cannot keep doing sins and chanting.
但是每一个人也同时应该理解到，他应该停止从事罪恶活动。
But if you think that by chanting Hare Krishna, then you can go on and do sinful things, then that's very bad. That's a big offense.
如果他认为可以一边唱 Hare Krishna, 一边继续从事罪恶活动的话，这是一个更大的冒犯。
But if by accident you do something sinful, you can be forgiven. But you shouldn't do it intentionally.
如果是由于意外你从事了一些罪恶的话，你可以被原谅，但是你不要有意的去从事一些罪恶。
So if somebody constantly hears and chants the holy name, and hears and chants about his activities, then very easily he can get pure devotion.
如果一个人很常的聆听和唱诵至尊主的圣名和活动的话，他可以很容易的达到纯粹的层面。
And pure devotion will of course clean the heart completely.
纯粹的幸福能够完全的清除一个人的内心的。
You can never get that kind of purification just by doing vows or just by performing rituals.
而只是通过遵守誓言或者伟大仪式，不可能达到这种完全清除内心污垢的。
But very easily, but if we practice chanting and hearing the holy name, we can come to the level of pure devotion.
但是通过聆听和唱诵主的圣名的话，我们可以很容易的达到这种纯粹的奉爱服的层面。
Even if we are chanting the Maha Mantra with offenses, we can get rid of the offenses if we keep chanting. Just keep chanting without stopping.
即便一个人他是冒犯者的唱诵 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗，他如果继续的持续不断的念诵和唱诵的话，他可以把这冒犯去除这些冒犯。
And somebody who keeps chanting.Then they'll never have to suffer any sinful reactions.
如果一个人持续不断的唱诵的话，他也会摆脱这种罪恶反应。
So Sukadeva Goswami wants Maharaj Parikshit to remember this.
Sukadeva Goswami 希望 Maharaj Parikshit 铭记这一点。
But if you just do Vedic rituals, there's no real benefit from that.
但是如果你只是做伟大仪式的话，没有什么益处。
You may go to the higher planets, and you may enjoy there for some time, but then you have to come back.
你或许会去到高等的星宿，然后去那里享受一段时间，但是你还能回来。
So you may go up and down in the universe, but it's better to chant the holy name and go back to Godhead.
你或许在这个宇宙上上下，但是比这更好的是唱诵圣名，回归受身。
So the devotees, they always want to get the taste of the lotus feet of the Lord.
一个奉献者，他总是想品尝至尊主莲花足下的。
Means that they want the taste of devotional service.
这意味着他总是想品尝奉献服务。
They want to avoid all material activities, which are under the modes of nature, material activities.
他就避免那些物质的活动。 被物质自然所影响的活动。
You know, material activity is only going to bring them suffering in the material world.
物质的这些活动只会给他在物质世界带来痛苦。
So, some people, they're very addicted to these Vedic rituals, and they don't want to serve Krishna's lotus feet.
有一些人特别喜欢这些仪式，但是内心他并不想去付出的莲花足。
So they still have many material desires.
还是有很多物质愿望。
So they're not purified, so they will come back to material world and they will do sinful activities again and again.
由于他没有得到完全的净化，所以他会一次又一次的从事罪恶活动。
But a devotee's duty is just to chant the Hare Krishna mantra.
但是奉献者的职责就是唱诵 Hare Krishna Mantra.
And even we may sometimes chant with offenses, sometimes we don't chant with, sometimes no offenses, sometimes there is offenses. But if we're just trying to follow this process, then gradually we will get perfection.
一个人有时会冒犯的唱诵，有时也会没有冒犯的唱诵。但只要他去执行这个程序，他会达到完美。
But people who just do Vedic rituals and who maybe they do atonements, they do not get any real benefit from these activities.
但是那些从事着伟达仪式和忏悔的人，不会得到真正的益处，不会达到这种完美。
So devotees.They're in the best position because they're completely detached from material pleasures.
奉献者是处于真正的完美，有物质世界。
But people who are doing Vedic rituals, they just want to enjoy the results. They have material desires and they want to enjoy the results again and again.
但是那些从事伟达仪式的人，他们想的只是想享受这个伟达仪式的结果，一次又一次的去享受这些结果。
So these people are like elephants bathing in the mud, bathing and then rolling in the dirt when they come out, and then they go and bathe and get clean, and then they roll in the dirt again. So these people are doing like that.
这些人就像沐浴之后，然后又自己弄。去到泥土里，然后又去沐浴，又把自己弄脏，然后又去沐浴。他们就是这样。
So the Yamadutas had heard about the glories of the chanting of the holy name from Lord Yamaraj, and they were very surprised to hear all this.
Yamaduta 从 Yamaraj 那里听到唱诵的圣名的荣耀之后，他们非常的惊讶。
So from that time on.Whenever they see a devotee, they're afraid of him, and they're afraid even to look at him.
自从那以后，他一见到奉献者，甚至都不敢看他们。
So they don't go near the devotees.
他们也不会再接近奉献者。
For the Yamaduras, a devotee is dangerous.
对亚玛都塔来说，奉献者是危险的。
So this whole history about the life of Ajamil, this was told to Sukadeva Goswami by a great sage called Agastya.
这个阿加米勒的这个故事是由伟大的圣者 Agastya 给圣 Sukadeva Goswami 讲述的。
So it's a very, very important pastime, and Srila Prabhupada lectured on this pastime a lot.
是非常重要的时光，而且圣帕帕德经常讲述这个笑，引述这个笑月时光。
And there are important verses in this section dealing with the power of the chanting of the holy name.
而且这里面有很多讲述唱诵圣名的力量。
The power of the holy name is so inconceivable that even though we don't chant it purely, but still it can act and it can save us from sinful reactions.
唱诵圣名的力量是非常不可思议的，即便我们不知道唱诵圣名的力量，但是这个力量还会在我们的唱诵之中，就是只要我们唱诵它，它就会起作用。
Of course, we have to be very careful not to take advantage of the holy name and think that we can do all nonsense and not suffer for it.
当然，我们也得非常小心，不要去利用这个圣名。我们not take advantage of this holy name.
Yes.We think that's the seventh offense, to commit sinful activity on the strength of chanting.
我们在唱诵圣名中的第八项是不要借着唱诵圣名去行恶。
第七个。To commit sinful activities on the strength of chanting.
借着唱诵主的圣名行恶，这是一种冒犯。
So, we are fortunate that we've been given the Sankirtan movement. We've been introduced to the chanting of the holy names.
我们非常幸运，我们得到了齐诵圣名，我们可以唱诵主的圣名。
Now we have to go on from there and become fully Krishna conscious.
我们可以从这开始变得完全具有能力。
Just like Ajamila, he heard the Yamaduras talking to the Vishnuduras, and he understood how he wasted his life.
就像阿加米勒，他从亚玛都塔和维什努都塔之间的这个谈话中听到了这个圣名，然后他理解到自己这一生是如何浪费了自己的这一生的生命的。
He understood that he had to give up all these sinful activities and yet take shelter of the Supreme Lord in devotional service.
他理解到他自己得放弃所有的罪恶活动，而且托庇于至尊主的莲花足。
So he immediately left home and he went to Hardwar and he stayed in the Vishnu temple and he prepared himself.Go back to Godhead.
于是立即的他就离开了家，去了哈德瓦，来到一个维什努都塔的庙宇，在那里准备离开自己的躯体。
And he was able to get perfection. He was able to go back to Godhead.
他是可以得到完美并回归守神的。
So we call that probably we have the book The Second Chance.
这是我们的第二次机会。
So Ajamila got the second chance, but we may not always get this. We may not be so lucky to get another chance ourselves. We've already been given a chance. We're already on our second chance.
阿加米勒得到了他的第二次机会，我们在第二次机会之中，但不是每一次我们都能得到这第二次的机会。
We may think I need the third chance, I need a fourth chance, I need a fifth chance. No, you won't get. We can't expect to get chances all the time.
我们想着我们有第三次机会、第四次机会，不，我们不要想着我们再有可能会得到这么好的机会了。
We have to take advantage now, make the best use of this life to go back home, back to Godhead.
我们得好好的利用这一次机会，好好利用这一次，人体的这个生命，准备回归守神，回归家园。
So we're going to go on next week to chapter 4.
下一次我们会讲第四章。
We'll hear about Prajapati Daksha and how he offers prayers to the Lord.
我们会听到 Prajapati Daksha 他是如何向至尊主供奉祷文。
Okay, so we'll stop here. Are there any questions?
Yes. First question from 徐一婷，顶拜尼星汉姑鲁，请问 ，First， 普通常念的那个和黑人亚卡西普有关的尼星汉祷文，是不是能在卧室里念？第二，最近躺在床上，似睡非睡的。非睡的状态中发现心里自动唱着这个祷文，马上就醒了，不敢继续念了，怕躺着再念更有冒犯，请问这是不是冒犯？如果有了冒犯，怎么样做忏悔呢？忏悔到什么程度才能消除冒犯的业力呢？ First question is whether we can chant the Nisinghā prayer in the bedroom.
Laying on her back, sleeping?
First question, she just asked whether can we chant this prayer in the bedroom?
Well, yes, you can chant anywhere, but the important point is when you chant, you have to have the right consciousness.
你可以在任何地方唱诵这个祷文，但是这个要点是我们在唱诵的时候应该有恰当的知觉。
Now,
okay.
Chanting of the holy name can be done anywhere.
唱诵主的圣名可以在任何地方。
All right, Lord Chaitanya was worried.That he was going to the, when he would go to toilet, he was worried that he would chant the holy name, so he tied a cloth around his mouth so he couldn't chant.
主柴塔尼亚也担心在厕所唱诵主的圣名是不是不好，于是他把自己的嘴给，就是给捏了起来，就不让自己在厕所里去唱。
But then a young boy said to him that.A young devotee's son said that what will happen if you die when you're in the toilet? You won't be able to chant the holy name. So when Lord Chaitanya heard this, he said to this little boy, you're right. And Lord Chaitanya agreed that he should chant the holy name.
于是一个 小男孩发现了这个 他就跟主柴塔尼亚说如果我们在厕所里唱没有唱诵主圣名，但是那个时候又死了怎么办呢？于是主柴塔尼亚说：“你说的是对的，我们应该任何时候唱诵，我们应该唱诵主的圣名。”
So you want to offer prayers in your bedroom? Well, yes, you can do it, but you have to have the proper consciousness. You're offering prayers.The prayers have to be offered with the proper mood.
你想在里面唱诵主的圣名，供奉这个祷文，这是非常好的。但是唱诵的时候要有好的心态，好的知觉。
It's not the best place to offer prayers, but you can do it. I don't. You have to consider what.Why are you choosing the bedroom to offer prayers?
你可以在你的卧室去唱，虽然那不是最好的地方，但是你也可以在那唱。但是你也得考虑，为什么你要在你的卧室？为什么你要选择在那个地方呢？
The best place to offer prayers is when you're in front of the Lord.So you go where you go to your temple room or where you have an altar and you stand in front of the altar and offer prayers there.
最好的供奉祷文的地方是在神像面前或者神，你可以去到你的神堂或者说你的神像面前，向在那里向至尊主供奉你的祷文。
When we offer prayers, we offer prayers with respect. And I don't know if your bedroom is the proper place to be offering, to be showing respect to the Lord.
当我们供奉的时候，我们还要怀着一种尊敬的心。我不确定你能否在你的里面，在供奉这个祷文的时候，怀有这种尊敬之心。
If you're going to meet somebody, some very great, very important personality, are you going to meet them in your bedroom?
如果你是想要去会见一个非常重要的，你会把这个重要的人放到你的卧室去引见吗？
You have to consider like this.
你得考虑一下这些事情。
So,
second,
it may be people, and maybe the rest of your home is not convenient. Maybe the other family members, they don't approve, and it's not convenient to offer prayers in front of all the other family members. And the bedroom is the best place. Okay, then you can do it.
如果你的情况是你的家里人，就是说你在家里的时候。供奉这个祷文并不是很方便，你的家人有所反对的话，而你的卧室是你目前所拥有的最好的地方的话，这个当然没问题，你可以在你的卧室里供奉这个祷文。
So you have to consider for yourself the, you know, the situation and decide what's the best place.
因此你得考虑一下你自己的情况是怎样，然后为自己选一个最好的地方。
Or if you just want to offer your prayers laying on your back on your bed because you're lazy, then it's not very good.
如果你只是因为懒惰，想在躺在床，在你的卧室的床上躺着供奉这个祷文的话，这个不是很好。
But at the same time, you can pray laying on your back.At the time of death, when we leave the body, if you can remember the Lord, it's very good.
但是如果你躺在床上去想着主的话，也是一件好的事情。当我们在离开躯体的时候，也是躺在床上。如果在那个之后也能想起主的话，这也是很好的。
Okay.
Yes.许一听还举手，我现在开了你的麦，你有什么话想说吗？请您把麦打开。
谁？
你得自己开麦。
你跟谁说话，萨蒂？
就是这个问问题的，
就是问问题的这位奉献者，他举手，他可能有要说话。我们可以让他说话吗，咕噜？
可以可以。我们不可以等那么久啊。
OK，
好，
我把他的第二个问题先说了吧，好不好？
Hare Krishna。
OK。
刚才是因为那个定音，他那个设置的问题，我调了，然后他说不能够，
OK，
主持人不能允许。
您说。
是这样子，我想请，就是我回答一下咕噜刚才的那个问题，就是对的，就是当时我去念那个尼西哈祷文的时候，因为是早上起来，我想在念诵之前，就是整个念十六圈之前，我想一边，因为我还要做念诵之前的准备，我就来回走，我一边走，然后我就要到卧室去拿东西，然后我就想为了节约时间，我就一边走一边念， 然后就回到厕所拿啊不回到卧室拿东西的时候，我就在念诵那个祷文。嗯，但是后来我念了以后，我又去了一下卫生间，我又看我脸色就不太对，我就在想这个是不是有点冒犯，我就想问一下姑姑。另外第二个呢，就是第二个问题就是，我不是说故意躺在床上故意去念你心想的那个祷文的，就是我躺在床上，比如说我可能比如说要休息一会儿，比如说午休啊那种休息一会儿，然后呢就是呢在那种似睡非睡的状态，它里边就自动在念那个你心想祷文。其实我就在想，我一下就醒了，我就马上就制止自己不能再念下去，我就怕这样有冒犯，因为之前有奉献者说念那个卡瓦塔，就是你心哈的卡瓦塔祷文是不能够在卧室里念的，并且还是要必须要在沐浴以后才能念，所以说呢，我对这个祷文我就不知道这个跟这个普通常念的我提的这个问题的这个祷文，它是不是可以在卧室里念，我就不确定是那样的。
OK， 我先把你的第二个问题先翻译一下啊。
好，
好不好？对，her second question is that when I lying on the bed in not intentionally, I chant this prayer automatically, and when conscious about this and I wake up and I'm not there to chant this mantra again. So I want to ask, when I lie on the bed and chant this mantra, is there any other offense?
No. Well, she's chanting it unintentionally. Yeah,
unintentionally.
It just comes in
automatically.
Her mind.
Yeah.
No offense.
如果你躺着不是那种有意的这种状态，是你这种描述的话是没有冒犯的。
She's not chanting for any purpose. It's just coming.
你唱诵，你唱诵的时候不是为了某种目的，而是一种自动的话，这没有冒犯。Then she asked, "When if I have offense, how to have some atonement?"
Well, chant properly. Chant in a devotional manner. You stand in front of the picture of the Lord and offer the prayers feelingly from the heart.
如果你唱诵的时候你觉得是有了一些冒犯的话，那你就以一种恰当的方式去唱诵，比如说去到你的神坛面前，以一种恰当的心态，发自你内心恰当的心态去唱诵。OK. Next question from Wow. 我对念诵十六圈有恐惧，害怕孤独，害怕有病，怕死，怕电闪雷鸣，没人在我身旁，下水道堵塞的时候，有病时旁边没人，所以念诵十六圈有恐惧。When I chant 16 rounds, I have some fear. I'm very frightened. I feel alone, and I fear of to get sick, and fear of death, a fear of lightning.So when I chanting the 16 rounds, I have some this kind of fear. How to do?
What is the fear?
He's very fear of loneliness, fear of sick, fear of death, fear of lightning.So when I chanting this 16 rounds, I have a lot of fear. How to do?
Well, I don't know how you have a lot of fear. Nobody else has a lot of fear when they're chanting. I don't know why you have a lot of fear. It's not coming from the chanting. It's not the result of chanting Hare Krishna that you're having fear. It must be some other purpose, some other reason.
我不知道为什么你会有恐惧，其他人在唱诵的时候没有恐惧，这而且唱诵圣名应该不会带来恐惧，你的恐惧一定是别的什么原因所造成的。
When we chant the holy name, we're with Krishna. We feel pleasure, we feel ecstasy. Why is it you're feeling fear? You're different from everybody else.
当我们唱诵圣名的时候，我们是和 Krishna 在一起，我们会感觉到快乐，我们会感觉到有喜乐。难道你和其他人有所不一样吗？
We chant Hare Krishna to help us to overcome fear.Because fear personified is afraid of Krishna.
我们唱诵圣名也是能够帮助我们克服恐惧，因为恐惧的人格化身都害怕 Krishna.
You cannot tell me that chanting Hare Krishna makes you fearful. This is not the cause of your fear.
你来告诉我，就是说你唱诵了这个圣名之后你就恐惧。
There must be some other reason why you have fear.
你一定是有其他的原因导致你的这种恐惧。
Go ahead.
Also from this friend.Krishna 在薄伽梵歌中说念诵 Om， 没有说念诵 Hare Krishna， 是帕帕德说念诵 Hare Krishna。 Krishna 在经典的什么地方说念诵 Hare Krishna？ This will also ask in next question. Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita just tell Arjuna to chant Om， but he didn't mention about Hare Krishna. Is just the Srila Prabhupada tell usChant Hare Krishna. Can you tell Krishna in which sastra he tell us to chant Hare Krishna?
In the Bhagavad Gita in chapter 10, Krishna says, of sacrifices, I am the chanting of the holy name.
在薄伽梵歌中的第十章 ,Krishna 说我是唱诵圣名，我是圣名的唱诵。
Then in the 9th chapter, Lord Krishna is describing the devotees, the Mahatmas, and he describes the Mahatmas, Satatam Kirtayanto Mam. He says they're always chanting my glories.
Krishna 在薄伽梵歌的第九章也讲到，那样一些人，他们很常唱诵着我的荣耀。
So chanting the holy name of the Lord.Is how we glorify Lord Krishna.
因此，唱诵主的圣名是我们荣耀主的方式。
The process of worshipping Lord Krishna in the Kali Yuga is by chanting His holy name.
在卡利年代，崇拜主的方式是唱诵主的圣名。
So Lord Chaitanya is teaching us how to worship Krishna through the chanting of the holy name.
主柴塔尼亚告诉我们是如何通过唱诵圣名的方式来崇拜主。
We should perform yagya. We should do sacrifice for the pleasure of Vishnu.
我们应该做祭祀，我们应该做 yagya 来崇拜主 Vishnu.
This is stated in the third chapter. Work done as a sacrifice for Vishnu has to be performed.Otherwise, that work binds one to the material world.
祭祀和牺牲一定得做，否则必将把人束缚在这个物质世界。
So the sacrifice in the Kali Yuga is the Sankirtan, the chanting of the holy name.
而卡利年代的祭祀牺牲就是齐颂主的圣名的运动。
And we are following the teachings of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and we accept Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as being the avatar of Lord Krishna, and he has come to teach us the Yuga Dharma.
我们接受主柴塔尼亚的教导，也接受主柴塔尼亚作为卡利年代的这个化身，而且他 ，Sorry, Gurudev. we accept Chaitanya as a Leela avatar.
No, we accept Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as being Lord Krishna, none different from Lord Krishna.
我们接受主Chaitanya跟主 Krishna 是没有区别。
And he has come to teach us the process of religion in the Kali Yuga.
他告诉我们在卡利年代修行的这个程序和方法。
And that process is the chanting of the holy name.
这个程序和方法就是唱诵圣名。
So there are many different names of the Lord.
主的圣名，主的名字有很多。
So you can chant Om. Yeah, Om is also a name of the Lord. Om is a, is representing the impersonal feature of the Lord.
Om 也是至尊主的一个圣名，它代表了至尊主非人格的这种特征。
Some people like to chant the holy name of Lord Vishnu, and there are 1,000 names of Vishnu.
有一些人喜欢唱诵主威士努的这个名字。 但是呢，主威士努还有一千个名字。And
1,000 names of Vishnu is equal to once chanting the holy name of Lord Rama.
唱诵主威士努一千遍，相当于唱诵主 Rama 这个词一次。And
that is stated in the scriptures.
啊，这也是在经典中有论据的。And
then it's also stated in the scriptures that three names of Rama is equal to one name of Krishna.
经典中同样还说，三次拉玛的名字相当于唱诵主 Krishna 这个名字的一次。And
so these the different names of the Lord all have powers. You have to understand the power of each of the holy name of the Lord.
主Krishna的不同的名字都有它不同的力量，你得了解这些力量。So
Lord Chaitanya taught everyone the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra.
主Chaitanya告诉每一个人唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra.
Because the Hare Krishna mantra can be chanted in tune with many different melodies and it becomes very attractive.
因为 Hare Krishna mantra 可以和很多的这些旋律结合在一起，这样它会变非常有吸引力。
But if you chant Om, 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 it's not very attractive, it becomes very dry. How long you can chant Om?
但是如果你唱 Om Om Om， 慢慢的，它会越来越干枯。你能唱多长时间的 Om 呢
？But chanting Hare Krishna mantra is very, very attractive. The more we chant, the more we want to chant, the more we get the taste of the chanting.
但是唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra 是非常具有吸引力的。你越唱诵，你越会得到唱诵的这个品味，你越会想要去唱诵。
So the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra is mentioned in the Bhakti Shastras. This Bhakti Shastras are those scriptures written by the followers of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra 在 Bhakti Shastra 就是分外的这些经典里面有描述，而分外的这些经典是来自于主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
And we see, we have just told the example from Srimad Bhagavatam, that's there, an ancient history, how Ajamil chanted the name Narayan.
而且在最近我们也聆听到了圣典波迦瓦谭关于这个罪恶的人阿加米勒他是如何唱诵的Narayana的这个圣名的。
And if you read the Srimad Bhagavatam, you can read about the history of Dhruva Maharaj. He chanted Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. He chanted the name Vasudevaya. That's also the name of the Lord.
如果你学习圣典波迦瓦谭，你了解到诸阿玛哈拉杰的这个逍遥时光和故事的话，你会发现他唱诵的这个圣名是 Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya， 而 Vasudevaya 这也是主 Krishna 的主的一个名字。
And from the Mahabharata, we read about Draupadi, how Draupadi was lost in the gambling match, and the Kauravas, they wanted to rip off her sari.
In Dopati 他是如何在赌博之中被输掉了，然后呢这些敌人他是想把他的沙瑞给拽下来。
So she surrendered herself to Krishna and she called the holy name of Krishna. She called out Govinda and the Lord appeared to her in the form of an unlimited sari and protected her.
她于是臣服了，臣服了主 Krishna。她在那个时候喊了主 Govinda, Oh Govinda。于是主 Krishna 在那个时候显现为就是无限长的这个沙瑞，以这种形式保护了多帕提。
So there are many examples of devotees who chanted the holy name, and they got perfection.
我们可以看到很多很多的例子，就是关于奉献者如何唱诵的至尊主圣名而得到保护，
so、
得到完美。
In every age, there's a different process for self-realization.
在每一个不同的年代，都有不同的程序。对于完美的方法有不同的程序。
Let's state it in Srimad Bhagavatam.
历代圣经佛教文坛有所讲述。
Srimad Bhagavatam is a graduate study of the Bhagavad Gita.
在学了佛家梵歌之后，你可以学这个圣典佛教文坛。
Bhagavad Gita is like the beginning of the spiritual knowledge, and it brings us to the point of surrender to Krishna.
佛家梵歌是我们觉悟自我的开端，它会把我们带到臣服于 Krishna 的这个终点上。
So once you surrender to Krishna, then you go on to the Srimad Bhagavatam.
当臣服主 Krishna 之后，你会来到 Bhagavat, 就是圣典佛家瓦坛的这个层面上。
So chanting of the holy name is the basic, is fundamental part of the practice of Bhakti Yoga.
唱诵主的圣名是 Bhakti Yoga 奉爱瑜伽的一个最主要的方式。
So the Lord has many names. So you want to chant Om, you can chant Om, but you have to chant it on your own. We chant Hare Krishna with the devotees, and we enjoy transcendental bliss in the association of devotees.You have to chant Om, you have to sit on your own and chant.
主有很多的名字，你可以，你可以唱诵你所选择的 Om, 但是呢，我们唱诵 Hare Krishna 是和奉献者一起唱诵 Hare Krishna, 我们在和奉献者的联谊之中，大家一起唱的 Hare Krishna, 但是你如果唱诵 Om 的话，你只能一个人自己去唱 Om.
Lord Chaitanya, when Lord Chaitanya,was a young man in Mayapur, he would see sometimes yogis sitting by the bank of the Ganga, sitting, meditating and chanting Om. He would throw water on them and he'd tell them, get up and chant Hare Krishna.
当主柴坦尼亚还是一个年轻，在马亚普的一个年轻人的时候，他看到很多在恒河岸边有很多的一些瑜伽师，他们唱诵了 Om, 于是主柴坦尼亚拿一些恒河水，泼在他们的身上，让他们坐起，让他们起来唱诵 Hare Krishna。
It's a much more powerful, better method of purification, chanting the Hare Krishna mantra.
这对于一个人的净化来说，唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra 是更为有效、更为有力量的一种方法。
The Hare Krishna mantra is a Vedic mantra. It comes from the Kali Santara Upanishad.
Hare Krishna Mantra 也是一个伟大的曼陀罗，它来自于卡利山塔乌帕尼沙的奥义书。
It's stated there, Iti so dasha kam nam nam, kali kamasha nashinam, mataparataro paya sarva vedi shudrishyate. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So the meaning is that these 16 words, Iti So Dasha Kam Nam Nam, the 16 words, meaning the 16 words of the Hare Krishna mantra, that they can purify all the dirt from the heart.
刚刚刚刚老师念到这个你这个梵文的这个意思是，这十六个词组成的 Hare Krishna Mantra 可以清除掉我们内心所有的污垢。
This is the essence of all the Vedas.
这是伟达经的所有的精华部分。
It is said the Lord Brahma has four faces and they're chanting the holy name.
而且说到主 Brahma 有四张脸，他每一个嘴巴都在唱诵圣名。
And Lord Shiva, he has five faces. They're also chanting the holy name.
主 Shiva 有五张脸，他全部都在唱诵主的圣名。
So, it's up to you. You want to chant Om? It's up to you. You go ahead. But we're chanting Hare Krishna mantra. Our chanting is authorized.
你唱诵 Om， 这是你的决定，这也根据你的决定。但是我们唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra， Hare Krishna mantra 也是来自于权威的。
This is the process of Bhakti Yoga.
这个是奉爱瑜伽 Bhakti Yoga 的程序。
And the Bhakti Yoga is at the top of the yoga ladder. It's the highest of all the different yoga systems.
而奉爱瑜伽是瑜伽阶梯之中最顶端。
But you're chanting a Om. That is not Bhakti Yoga. That's some other process.
如果你唱诵 Om 的话，这不是奉爱瑜伽，是其他的这个程序。
Okay.
Next question from 风爱瑜伽，顶拜老师和大家，您刚才说仆人犯错，主人会承担责任。有奉献者打着灵性导师的名义向其他奉献者要布施给灵性导师，这是对孤儒的服务吗？或者这恰不恰当？这并不恰当。A basis to you.You mentioned in the class, when the servant makes some mistake, the master will respond for that. So, for example, when devotees represent the spiritual master, in other way and ask the devotees to give the donation to the spiritual master, is this the loving service to the spiritual master, whether it properly.
We should be very cautious about this.
我们应该很小心这一点。
Without hearing from the spiritual master directly, we should not take the words of other devotees that they want to collect money for the spiritual master.
除非是从灵性导师那里直接得到这种言语的话，我们不要去聆听任何其他人借着灵性导师的名义去收集钱的这种情况。
Spiritual master does not want money. He wants to see devotees become Krishna conscious.
灵性导师并不需要钱，他希望他的奉献者能够具有 Krishna 知觉。
You want to please the spiritual master, you will please him the more you get rid of material desires.
你如果想取悦灵性导师的话，你应该越多的去免于物质的欲望。
Nobody should think that I will please my spiritual master by collecting money from devotees and give the money to the spiritual master.Without permission from the spiritual master, that's not right.
任何人不要认为我借着灵性导师名誉向收集钱，然后把这个钱给了灵性导师，这是一种取悦的方式，这并不是正确的。
Doesn't please the spiritual master.
这不会取悦灵性导师。 next question?
Yeah.
Okay. Next question also, okay, Sati Manaji.
Good day. 我们已经九点了，然后后面还有几个问题，您还可以吗？
可以。
还能回答吗？还是我们把这些问题留到周二的早上再回答？
因为在这里只有六点半，所以我有时间。
好的，那好，我们可以继续。
Okay. This question also from Wao. 他说，还有 Narada Muni， 他也不是念诵 Hare Krishna， 他念的是 Narayana， 对吧？难道他不如我们这些唱诵 Hare Krishna 的人有分爱吗？阿加米勒的圣名也是 Hare Krishna 吗？那是主 Chaitanya 传送的圣名。This Wao also asked, the Narada Muni also not chant the Hare Krishna mantra, he chant the Narayana.Whether he have much more devotion than us, we chant the Hare Krishna devotees. And Ajamila also chant the Ajamila also not chant the Hare Krishna. This Hare Krishna is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu brought.
Yes, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu brought the highest thing.
是的，主 Chaitanya 带来的是最高的。
Because he's bringing everyone to the level of Braja Bhakti, the mood of the devotees in Vrindavan.
因为他带来的是 Vrindavan 的这一个心态。
So, if you're chanting the name of Narayan, like you say Narada Muni and Ajamila, then you won't go to Goloka, you'll only go to Vaikuntha. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is teaching everybody to go to Goloka. He wants to cultivate the mood of the gopis. He says the gopis are the best devotees of Krishna.
如果你像 Narada Muni 或者说阿加米勒他们所唱诵的《Narayana》的话，你可以唱诵这个《Narayana》，但是你不会去到 Goloka， 你会去到 Vaikuntha。主 Chaitanya 带来的这个 Hare Krishna Mantra 是 Braja Bhakti， 他带的是文达文牧牛姑娘的心态，因为他认为的者之中，牧牛姑娘们是最高的。
So Rupa Goswami was appreciating Lord Chaitanya.That he came to give the highest thing.
Rupa Goswami 在他经典非常欣赏主 Chaitanya 一点是他主 Chaitanya 一点是他带来的是最高的。
And even Narada Muni, he wanted also to come into. He wanted to also see the pastime of Rasa Lila. He was attracted to become a gopi.
即便是 Narada Muni， 他也非常渴望想去参加到 Rasa Lila 之中，他也想成为一个牧牛姑娘。
So at one point, even Narada Muni became a gopi.
因此，有一次 Narada Muni 也成为了一个凤仪，成为了一个牧牛姑娘。
So he got the name Naradi. Naradi, feminine name of a woman, gopi.
他成为了这个 Naradi， 这是一个牧牛姑娘的名字。
But Krishna knew, and Krishna said, "Who are you? Where are you from? What village are you from? I don't know you. What gopi are you?"
Krishna 却识别了这个 Naradi， 他说：“你是从哪里来的？我并不知道你，我以前也没有见过你。
”So Narada Muni doesn't belong in.Goloka Vrindavan.
因此 Narada Muni 他并不属于 Goloka Vrindavan.
If you want the highest thing, you have to go to Goloka.
如果你想要最高的话，你得去到 Goloka Vrindavan.
And to go to Goloka, you have to develop love for Krishna.
如果你想去 Goloka 的话，你得发展出对 Krishna 的爱。
Lord Narayan is worshipped in the mood of.Opulence with great awe and reverence. So in Vaikuntha, the mood is to be the servant of the Lord.
主拿尔央呢，以富裕，就是这种富裕被崇拜者。但是呢，如果去到格罗卡的话，那里的主是那里的主，就是我们对他是一种仆人之心。
Now in Vaikuntha, the mood is to be servant.
Okay, sorry. 在 Vaikuntha, 我们是一种仆人的心态。
But in Goloka, we can enjoy so many rasas with Krishna.
但是在 Goloka 的话，我们可以与 Krishna 享受很多的关系。
You can be Krishna's friend, you can be Krishna's mother or father, and you can be lover of Krishna.
你可以成为 Krishna 的朋友，你也可以成为 Krishna 的母亲或父亲，你也可以成为 Krishna 的爱女。
But in Vaikuntha, everybody is servant.
但是在 Vaikuntha, 所有人都是仆人。
So it's a different mood.
这是一种不同的心态。
So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he taught people to follow in the mood of the gopis.
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 告诉我们要以牧牛姑娘们的心态。
Okay.
Next question from Vaishnavivani Madhaji. He said with English.Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, how much time it will take for a sinful soul to come up to the level of Lama Bas or even higher? Is it possible for anyone? Sometimes it appears very difficult just to overcome inattentive and sleep during chanting. Thank you.哈利克纳古尔玛尔拉吉，就是说，到底要花多长时间？对于一个罪恶的灵魂，到底要花多长时间才能到达纳玛巴斯，或者说更高的层面呢？因为经常，这是不是对于每一个人来说，有不有可能对每一个人来说都能到达这种层面呢？有的时候好像非常难以克服。就是即便是在唱诵的过程中要保持这种专注和不睡觉都是一件难以克服的事情。Thank you.
So it depends on the individual. It can happen very quickly. Very quickly one can come to the level of Namabhas. And for others it may take a very, very long time.
这个取决于每一个个人的个体情况。对于有一些人他们可能会很快的时候就到达这个 Namabhas 的这个层面，但是对于有一些人可能要花很长的时间。
So we have to get over these tendencies to sleep and to chant without proper attention. We have to try to absorb ourselves in the holy name.
为了克服这种不专注或者说想睡觉还有其他一些不恰当的行为的话。我们得完全沉浸在圣名之中。
But there's no fixed time.
但是没有确定的时间说怎么样。
We want to have the fixed determination.
我们要有固定的决心，坚定的决心。
That we want to achieve this. We want to get the real mercy of Krishna, we want to taste the nectar of the holy name, we have to have that eagerness, that intense desire, then we can get it.
我们要坚定的决心想要得到这种品味还有这种渴望的话，那么我们才能够得到这个情况。
Okay.
She said, more chanting is one way to overcome intensive chanting as you have already told.
Yes, right.
Yes. 就是说更多的唱诵是克服不专注的念诵的一种方法。Next question from Chaitanya Charam. 顶拜孤乳和奉献者们，如果奉献者自杀，归阎罗管还是归主 Krishna 管？ 自杀的奉献者的结果会怎样。 Obeisance to Gurudev and when the devotee suicide is he belonged to Yamaraj or belonged to Krishna? Suicide devotee, what's the result for him?
Well, it depends on many things. It will depend a lot on the mood of the devotee. How much of a devotee was he? What was his mood? Why did he do this? You know, there's many things to be considered.
就是要评判这一点，需要考虑很多的条件和因素。到底这个奉献者的心态是怎样的？他为什么要这么做？
One thing is you don't go back to Godhead just by committing suicide.
有一点要说的是，一个人如果自杀的话，他肯定不会回到灵性世界。
Not immediately.
不会回归受身。
Not immediately.
不会回归受身。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Sati Manji. 亲爱的奉献者，哦，还没上。Next question from Shyam Sunda. 顶拜 Guru， 请问我的灵魂，我是灵魂，并是永恒的。灵魂永恒的证明是什么？A basis to Guru, I want to ask, I'm the soul and is internal. What is the certification of the internal soul?
What is the certification?
How to prove the internal soul?
Well, you have to accept.Scriptures.
你应该从经典中寻找。
But generally, it's understood, just like when a person dies, what do we say when a person dies? Usually we may say, they have gone, or they have left us, indicating that they've gone some other place.
比如说我们通常有一个情况就当有人死了之后，我们会说什么呢？他走了，他已经去到了别的地方。
So we have also many examples of people who remember past lives.
我们还有也有一些很多人他记得过往的生活。
A lot of research has been done on that. Children who remember their previous lives.
有很多的研究调查就是关于也表明有很多的小孩他记得前生。
And some people have had near-death experiences. Sometimes they were in they were in a medical operation and maybe their heart stopped for some time and then they came back to life.
还有很多这种濒临死亡的案例，比如说他在做手术的时候，他差不多快要死了，但是突然又他又回来了。
So there are different. Generally, any thoughtful person can understand that the soul is eternal.
不管怎样，任何有思想的人都能理解灵魂它是永恒的。
This point is explained in the Bhagavad Gita, the difference between the body and the soul.
这个要点在《薄伽梵歌》中也有所阐释，就是关于躯体和灵魂的区别。
If you have difficulty accepting this, then chant Hare Krishna, and you can experience the spirit soul within your body.
如果你对此还有所困难的去对此理解还有所困难的话，你可以唱诵 Hare Krishna， 这样你就可以理解这个永恒的灵魂和躯体的区别。
Hare Krishna，
Hare Krishna。Second， he asked， 所有的物质都有业报。 都受物质自然三属性控制，请问孤乳有哪种哪三种？ All the material all have karma and are controlled by the material modes of nature. Three modes of nature. I want to ask a guru, which are the three modes?
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
我觉得这个问题让他自己去读书就可以了。
Okay.
我已经告诉他读、
okay.
去读十四章啊。
Okay.
下来。
Next question from 小白妈的姐 ，Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Guru， 我儿子八岁，他有一次在卧室听到一个奇怪的声音，吓得喊着跑了出来。这个声音也描述不清楚，说之前也听到过两次，之后，以后最近一段时间他变得很胆小，说害怕有鬼魂，在家里都需要我离他很近，请问 Guru， 我该怎么办？感恩你。Hare Krishna, a business to Guru. My son is eight years old. Sometimes, one time he listened for sound from the bedroom and come out from the bedroom. I can't remember this, how to describe this sound. And recently, after that, my son become very timid and he fear about ghost. When at home, we should be very close and then not be very fearful. So I want to ask a guru, what should I do? Thank you.
You should chant Hare Krishna and play Hare Krishna.
你应该唱诵，对呀。
Play Hare Krishna Kirtan.
你应该唱诵 Hare Krishna, 然后做这个 Hare Krishna 的唱诵 Kirtan.
Keep your home very clean and pure.
保持你的家庭干净纯洁。
Don't have any contaminated foodstuffs or alcohol in the home.
不要让那些很污染的食物放在家里面，比如说酒精、酒。
And regularly chant the holy name and worship Krishna.
有规律的唱诵圣名，然后崇拜 Krishna.
You can also worship Lord Nrisimhadev.
你也可以崇拜主尼辛哈德。
And it will help to bring auspiciousness into your home.
这也能够帮助你的家里不再那么的 不吉祥。
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Next question from Sam Mohini Devadasi. 顶拜 Guru, 请问有时涟漪之后荣耀和沙的没有吃饱的感觉，嘴巴不停的想要吃东西，为什么会这样，怎么办呢？A basis to Guru, when after association with devotees, I honor the prasadam, but I didn't feel very full. I also have desire to eat more. Why it happened like this? How should I do?
Well, you have the desire to eat more prasadam, that's good. You can eat more, we don't mind.
如果你想要吃更多的普沙丹，你就去吃吧，你不要介意，这是一个好事。
Prasadam is purifying. You eat more prasadam, you get more purification.
普沙丹是有净化的，你吃越多的普沙丹，你可以得到越多的净化。
Especially, we're not very long time in Krishna consciousness.So it's good for us to eat more prasadam.
尤其是我们很长时间都没有 Krishna 知觉的话，我们吃很多的 prasadam 也是好的。
Now, Amy, what do you say? So, Amy, you didn't like Krishna 知觉，不是很长时间，所以。
Okay. 因为你在 Krishna 知觉进来加入 Krishna 知觉不是很长时间，所以吃很多的 prasadam。 也是好的，
是好的，
对，
嗯嗯 ，OK
OK，
还有
question 没有了，
哦、oh, OK
OK，
所以我们感谢所有的奉献者。感谢苏布里瑞普布给我们翻译，感谢萨提马特基主任，感谢所有的奉献者聆听，祝福你们，保护身体健康，注意安全，多保重。Hare Krishna， 释迦牟尼佛，
拜。
拜。
好，我们。